for what's right. Fight for your life. How about Tom Shields can figure out how to use this freaking controller? You know, oh, there we go. All right, we got it now. What's going on, people? It's Tom Shields Live. That's right. What do you think, huh? The thing is, it's not as easy as you look. A lot of people say, what is this show all about? What's this guy raising the volume of his voice for? What's going to happen here tonight? There are 60 minutes of these two people. I'll tell you what, folks. It's a show of complaints, and I'm going to look over here just to make sure that we have some good audio going, because last week we had some problems, baby. Let me tell you, I was in a bad mood. I never get in a bad mood. Never get, Cheryl, you know that. I'm always smiling. I never get in a bad mood. I'm always, sounds good, Cheryl. Every once in a while, type that in, and it makes me feel a whole lot better. It's like my security blanket when I see someone say, Tom, yeah, you sound darn good, and I'm sorry that I was cranky last week, everybody. All the people that just loved me, I am sorry that I was cranky. But it's not going to happen tonight, Lisan. What's going on, babe? Good, Lisan. And that's how you always answer the phone. Hi, Tom. How are you? Or when you call me, and I know it's you because I see your phone. Tom, it's Lisan. How are you? And I know, that's great. That is a very upbeat. I know. How are you? That's why I'm always afraid if when we have a guest on the show, that like Joy, when she was here, she was a terrific, I mean, she was talking so much, I just wanted to, no, I'm kidding. No, she was very good. But sometimes you'll get a guest that just has yes or no answers.
Oh, that's
and that horrible. Freaks you out. That can freak
or
you
that
out.
Monotonous, that it's just like,
yeah.
Kind of feeling in there.
Right, right.
Emotion.
Yeah, exactly. Well, Lisan has a new microphone tonight. She's not using the handheld, so she's gonna be a little quieter than the main guy right here. I'm the main guy, and I'm allowed to be a little bit louder than she is. So let me see. I'm telling you, folks, it's unbelievable. Tom Shields Live, Tom and Lisan show right here. We're seen across the country. That's right, the United States of America and the world, actually, in Canada. Anybody can watch us as long as they come to the Stick Network and check in and they can see what's going on.
Our Australian friends.
Mm-hmm. Anybody across the country, across the world can see what it is to be a United States a citizen.
That's right, a real American.
To be living in the U.S. of A, and everybody says, well, Tom, what's the problem? Why are you getting all worked up? Well, I'll tell you what. You try being an entrepreneur and watch President Obama come on television, and all he freaking wants to do is get construction workers back to work. Did you watch his freaking... I wanted to kick the TV in.
Oh, my God.
I wanted to kick my foot through the freaking television.
You're
because
right,
all he does... You know, he talks about other, but his main objective is to get these freaking construction workers back to work.
You know what else he did? You know, don't pull my heartstrings with just the teachers and the firefighters and the police officers. Yes, they need to have jobs too, but what about regular Americans?
That's what I mean.
I mean, do we have to be a government worker to have a job?
You have to have you have to be in a union to be a construction
right.
worker, or you have to be in a union to be a railroad worker,
absolutely.
Or then that's it. And if you're not experienced in being a railroad, or you're not
or
experienced
connected.
Or in construction, then he's not for you. Who, what the hell is this guy doing? Come on, I feel, you know, I feel it coming on. people, think about it. People are tuning in right now and they're saying, oh, what's going on here? You got to get fired up. You know what I mean?
I mean, honestly, what about that whole solar panel thing? Remember we talked about it a few months ago. Now it turns out it's one of his friends that he gave $500
million. $500
million
he gave to, and he said, oh, green jobs, we need this guy. Is screwing up this country more than people can. And there's still supporters of President Obama.
Well, you know what they tried to do? They tried to blame Bush for this too.
Oh.
Well, that was a Bush policy. Wait a minute. He's in the factory taking credit for it. Now
you know,
up in his face. It's Bush's fault.
It's just it's like you're trying to blame Papa. It doesn't matter. You're not blaming Big Papa anymore. Hey, you're a big boy now, President Obama, and all his constituents and all his followers, you're big people now. You're going to take responsibility. He took the job on to correct this. He came on with his big mouth and said he was going to fix everything. If he didn't come out and say that right off the bat, that he was going to be the Messiah, that going to fix everything, maybe we wouldn't have held him to such a high standard. But he opened up his mouth, promised us things that never came true, and what are you going to do about it? You're going to sit back all the time and say, well, President Bush caused this. President Bush was the reason this happened. President Bush is the reason. Yeah. I'm right here, you know? Get out there and fix it.
It's like when there's a problem, blame Bush. You could be taking the credit, standing in the factory saying everything's great because of me, and then the minute something goes wrong, it's Bush's fault.
And the funny thing is, the good thing about this show, too, I know Bush, everybody wants to blame Bush. Everybody, you know.
Let me tell you, Bush on 9/11? I'm sure there were a lot of people at home thinking, oh, man, I miss Bush.
Yeah, I know.
Wow, that looks like a real president right there.
Do you know, I went 9/11. I was on Ground Zero.
You were?
9/11. I was there.
Did you see Bush?
No, I didn't see Bush. I got there a little late, but I took some pictures.
Oh, wow.
of the tower there and everything else. I was in New York City, ladies and gentlemen, on 9/11. And here, let me see if I can shove this in the camera and see if you guys can see it.
I think people would love to see this.
This is one of the buildings that's next to, I don't know if you can see that.
Yes, what building is that?
That is one of the buildings next to the big tower that they're building. It's like another tower that they're building. I'm not sure what it is. But also, let me show you. This is the main tower. These are my pictures, folks. This is me taking the picture of this main tower.
Wow. That's
you see
gorgeous.
It?
Is that the Freedom Tower?
That's the Freedom Tower.
It's beautiful.
There it is. In person, it's absolutely breathtaking. It's beautiful.
Yeah, there's the World Financial Center. Right?
Yeah, it's not completely completed.
Right.
But the thing is, it's absolutely breathtaking. And I was there 9/11, and let me tell you, you want to talk about how many police officers New York City employs. There were more police officers present that day than I ever thought possible that New York City could employ. I mean, you'd walk down the street, there was actually like a congregation, there was hundreds of them in areas, and you'd walk to other areas, hundreds of police officers. And from what I understand, there's something like 43,000 police officers in New York City. That's what I found out. But I was there, folks, and I don't live too far from. I mean, we live here in Connecticut. So
my husband goes to New York every day.
Yeah, so it's not a big deal. I mean, it's just you take the train down and that's the end of it. But the thing is, you know, I ride the subways and everything. I took the subway all the way down. I took the subway over. I had a little Japanese restaurant, and you know, I ate my little Japanese food. I had a little Japanese beer.
Sounds like you had fun.
I did. I was by myself. I had a good time, and I said, you know, I said to the lady, she goes, "What do you want to drink?" I said, "I'm gonna have a beer." Mm-hmm. "What kind of beer you want?" And I didn't know the Japanese beers. I says, "I want something that tastes like a Budweiser." And she went, she went back, got me a beer, and son of a gun, that was good.
Really?
It was good. So that's what I did. I went down to the 9/11 memorial. And then I was trying to get in to see the fountains that they built in the footprint of the Twin Towers, you know, all that nice stuff. And it wasn't open.
It didn't open, I think.
It opened the next day.
Yeah.
The next day they let people in.
And you have to, like, get on a waiting list.
There's tickets or something. Mm-hmm. Do you have to buy them? I don't know.
I don't think you have to buy them. I think they just want to check you out and make sure they know who you are first.
All right. All right, what's going on? We got some problems with sound? What's going on? It's just that, it's Tom Shields Live. That's the name of the show.
also slash Tom and Lisa's show. So I get to be a little louder.
Yeah.
You know, and you get, you know, that's all there is to it. How's that for an excuse? I don't know, we might bring back the other mic. I mean, that mic is like right on, but you know, we're trying something new. But anyhow, the thing is why does Obama, you know, it drives me crazy. It makes me want to throw my foot right through the television when I hear him. And from what I understand, he's going to be having a speech tomorrow or the next day where he's going to have a bridge in his background as he gives a speech of how he wants to put construction workers back to work. Instead of helping the private sector, folks, this is just a little show. This is a show with just a couple of regular Americans. I don't hold a Harvard degree. I didn't take a journalistic course. I didn't go to school for communications. I just came on here and have passion about what's going on in the country and what's going on in my life, okay? Maybe other people, you get comedians on there. Oh, they make jokes. This is coming right from the gut, which I have quite a gut every once in a while. I look in the thing. But the thing is, you know, we're not getting any younger. We're only on this merry-go-round once. Why not make it? Why not stand up for what you believe in? What are you going to do, folks? You're going to sit back and go, boop, 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 boop.
I don't want anybody not to like me.
Yeah.
I say something that people
Everyone's worried. Oh. Are you worried about what people will think of you if you speak out?
Tom, that's my problem, is that I think I need to learn how to worry. Because, you know, I'm myself, and it's like, take me or leave me, but I have integrity. And that's one thing.
Right.
I can look myself in the mirror. The minute I don't have integrity and I do compromise my values,
yes,
because I don't want to make somebody angry, I hate myself.
Because you have a burning in you. You have this fire in you that you want to talk about what you believe is right and wrong.
You're alive.
Yeah,
I'm
exactly. Alive. We can't say anything to try to make a difference, and if we do, we're frowned upon. I mean, come on.
Especially when you see the country getting wrecked. I'm sorry, this isn't like, I'm not crazy about that pattern. No, this is something that's really important, like Tom's bicep.
No, go. I get carried away. No, but you're absolutely right. And I just can't figure out why people, let's take a look.
Look, everybody's like, Tom, you're
thank you, Cheryl. I'm telling you, I work hard at it, babe. I know, but I don't think it's on. What's not on? Oh, you know what I took? Speaking of being on, you watch MSNBC? Do you ever turn
yes.
it on? You know Rachel Maddow.
Oh my God, she's a disaster.
What goes through? You know how people grow? You're always learning something new
Rachel
in life.
Has never had anybody disagree with her to her face.
Let me show you something. Let me get this thing out of the computer. Hold on a second.
Rachel Maddow. Oh.
What is it with? Like, you know how sometimes when you're young, you think like, ooh, even though you don't wear glasses, you think like, well, maybe if I wear glasses, I'll look cool. Or look, you know, or
I'll look just like Clark Kent.
Or maybe if you wear glasses, you'll look like, woo! Ric Flair, baby, yeah! What do you think? You know, you put on the glasses, you become that individual. You put on the glasses, woo, baby, woo! You see what I'm talking about? It's just unbelievable. And as soon as you put them, woo, baby, yeah!
That's great!
You know? But Rachel Maddow uh-huh. did a commercial, you know, like MSNBC has this new thing now. Mm-hmm. They say lean forward. That's their logo.
I know, I've seen that lean forward.
What does that, what?
I have no
what
idea
does that mean?
Lean forward means. I know
that. The marketing director of MSNBC knows what it means, but I don't know what it means. What the hell does lean? I know what lean forward like we're moving forward in life or MSNBC.
We're
lean forward. What we want to lean forward to make the world a better place. What the hell is MSNBC talking about? I wish they'd just come on or call me on the phone. What do we got? We got a phone number right here. You want to call on the phone? Call me right now and tell me what lean forward means. I don't understand. They even have commercials. Here's Rachel Maddow. No, I'm serious, folks. I have no idea. Type in what you think lean forward means on the MSNBC logo. They have the new, what do you call it? Their new slogan. Let's see if...
How's that, Phillips? You want to keep moving or you want to run the friggin' video? All right, thank you.
Oh, okay, here we go.
Now, let me see. They're all wing nuts. I think it means bend over. That's Oompa Loompa said that.
Oh, God.
They mean to listen to us. Cheryl might have it right, like lean forward to closer to the TV.
Like
if the TV is right here, mm-hmm. you lean forward so it's right in front of your frickin' face. I don't know, I can't figure out what lean forward means, but I tell you one thing, this is the terrible side of my face. Did you know that?
So you need to stay on the good side.
I watch these shows when they air mm-hmm. because we have, this is a live program, folks. What's today, the 15th?
Yep.
September 15th, it's 9:16 on the East Coast, which means it's 6:16 on the West Coast. And wherever you are in between, that's what time it is for you. Now, the thing is we're doing it live, but we also tape this show for rebroadcast in the Brantford, Connecticut area, because that's where we live.
Right.
And I watch the show sometimes, and when I look over at you and I laugh, I just... I look like, this is what I picture myself looking like. Like, I have this, I don't know, I have this really gawky, goofy, like fat-faced laugh. I don't know, it drives me freaking crazy. Charlie! Where you been, Charlie? Son of a gun. See, folks, and not only...
You'll have cam if you watch us live, too.
That's right, you can watch us live. Right. The thing is if they saw the website earlier, go to the website, but nobody's calling in to everyone's afraid to talk to us, so let's just keep the website up. The thing is, you go to the website, you can find out all about live. Mm-hmm. You know who's doing internet television now? Glenn Beck.
I know.
He has watched my show. No. I wonder if I was his inspiration. He's going on internet television now. And that's, you know what, he has subscribers that you got to pay mm-hmm. a monthly fee to watch his show on a daily basis. I'd like to get into that kind of thing. But
why not, right?
Yeah, I know. But the thing is Glenn Beck is now getting into internet television. Tom Shields, me, and Lisan, we are in internet television. I know a lot of
pioneer
people do right the internet television thing. We get a little carried away with the cameras, the lights, and the studio. But why not, if you're going to do a show, why not feel it?
And do it right.
You gotta feel it. You gotta have the equipment around, even if it doesn't mean anything. You gotta have the equipment around.
It does mean something because we have our monitors. You know what cam you're on.
Oh, let me see. Tell him to read what I wrote about MSNBC. What'd you write, Cheryl? Charles, Tom, read. All right. MSNBC announced its new slogan, "Lean Forward," part of a plan to give itself a clear, progressive political position. And brand itself as a sure, those words are too big for me. All right, here we go.
Ooh, cool.
What did I say? I don't hold a Harvard degree, but I'll tell you one thing. I have the ability to speak my mind, and we take live phone calls. I believe we have a caller on the line. Oh. Caller, you are on live with Tom and Lisa. What's going on, babe?
Hey, it's Leon.
Leon! Leon, I tell you what's going to mess you up. By having your computer turned up, it's going to mess you up when you're trying to talk to us. They'll be like, you'll be waiting to hear yourself, and there's a little bit of a delay, so you're better off just turning the volume right down on your computer and just chatting with us right here.
Okay.
Watch, he's going to give it a go. And watch how better. Then you'll be like more connected. It'll be like, wow, this is like a real phone call.
That is so cool. What's up, Leon?
Hey, I just wanted to say I'm sorry I missed you guys tonight, but good show so far.
Yeah, thanks.
Thank you.
Actually, Leon, I even had a microphone set up for you tonight just in case you want to make a guest appearance at any time. The door is unlocked. You could come right in. I have a microphone set up for you now, and I have a camera set up for you. So you are...
There's a whole area waiting for you.
Right. You are more than welcome to join the program at any time.
Well, I'm watching you guys live, and it looks really good. Except, Tom, stop flexing.
I know. I can't control myself. I am a little narcissistic. I like to watch myself on the monitor, and I can't control it.
Well,
it's something in my being. It's something in my blood. I can't figure it out. But I'll try to, when I seek therapy, I'm sure I'll be able to figure it out then.
I'm just giving you a hard time. It looks good. You guys are doing a good show.
All right, Leon. Well, thanks for watching. We'll have to say a couple things to you now that we know you're watching, and we hope that you watch the whole 60 minutes, which there's only 40 minutes left of the program.
Leon
has a question for you.
What did you think of Rachel winning Big Brother last night?
Do you really want my opinion on that? First of all, I knew she was going to win when it came down to the final two, but she played a good game. She did deserve to win, but I didn't want her to win.
Well,
and because I'm on TV, I'm not going to curse.
All right. Good thing, because then I'd have to go and edit it and takes friggin' hours. So, all right, Leon. Well, I'll tell you what. Thanks a lot, and thanks for your input on the Big Brother deal. And Lisa appreciates that. And keep watching the show. We're going to say a couple of funny things about the Brantford area.
All right. You guys have a good show.
All right. Thanks. Bye. Bye-bye.
Talk to you later. Bye.
There we go. See that?
That was awesome. That's nice having you.
I know. And not only was he excited, he had the computer turned up. The volume was so high, it was feeding through the mic. That son of a bee. Let's give him the audience applause. You got to do something good in order to get the audience applause. But folks, I'm telling you one thing, you got to join the bandwagon. How could you not like a show like this? I mean, really, it's animated. I don't think we're boring. Because if we were boring, you'd fall asleep. I'd fall asleep. You'd start yawning. And imagine if we just sat here and went, the next thing we're going to talk about, folks. I mean, that's not who we are.
Not at all.
And I don't think our viewers would want to see something like that. And the thing is, folks, we want you to enjoy the show. We want you to go on the website, become a fan, because we're talking about real issues. We're talking about real issues that happen locally in your town, that happen
across the country.
Across the country.
That affect the world.
Absolutely, it affects the world. It affects you and me. I'm telling you, if I hear President Obama talk one more time about—and I tell you what, folks—he's coming on. I don't know when his speech is. Again, I heard it on the radio tonight. He's going to be doing another speech somewhere with a bridge behind him because he's talking about the construction workers. Why? Because if you're a construction worker, what are you affiliated with?
A union.
Mm-hmm. And the union wants, that's the thing. Unions are almost like government control because they control the worker. The worker could go out and smoke herb, get loaded, and they'll still be able to keep their job because they got the union behind them. And what does a union do except for the union, the heads of the union to collect money? Mm-hmm. It's all about money. That's it. Unions, what are they? They have these so-called rules that help you keep your job and give you benefits and pensions and, well, that doesn't sound too bad.
No, it sounds great. But what the problem is for me with a lot of the government unions is that it's money laundering. So it's my tax dollars going to the union fees that are going to a party that I don't necessarily agree with. And I don't
absolutely
think that's right.
I don't
that's,
either.
They are taking our money and putting it towards whatever they want to fund.
You know what?
Uh-oh. Wow, look at this. Maybe we're going to get somebody saying, let me tell you something.
But I didn't have the phone number up, so this is going to be someone that...
Hi, good evening.
Good evening. How can I help you?
I'm calling up about the Equinox.
The what?
I'm selling a Chevy Equinox on Craigslist. I'm sorry, sir. You've actually called a live television program. But we're gonna have to let you go now. But thank you very much. It's been sold.
Okay, thank you.
Where are you calling from?
New Haven.
Let me ask you a question. Since you're live on the air right now, you're actually on a national television broadcast.
and it's not a joke.
What are your thoughts of President Obama? Do you think he's doing a good job, or do you think he's doing a terrible job? What's your view?
Well, I haven't seen a change yet.
Good, yeah, well, good.
I still see things that are going bad, our taxes and stuff.
Yeah, exactly. Well, here we go. Here's a cold guy. Here's a guy that I just throw in this question. I'll tell you what, caller, if you want to go on your computer and you want to look up www.shieldstv.com, you'll see the show that you've just been talking on.
Okay, thanks.
All right, buddy, bye-bye.
He doesn't
care. I got an ad on Craigslist for a car I'm selling.
and I have the studio number listed on the freaking phone.
How hilarious is that? I'm calling about
the Chevy Equinox. I thought, and you're like, yeah, we got somebody calling to really give us the go. You know, they're gonna give us the business. Well, I was trying to get the business, but really, you know, I could talk all night. There's sometimes, folks, I get so emotionally involved mm-hmm. in what this country is going through and the thoughts and ideas that President Obama has that I get so emotional sometimes that I'm almost going to throw up. I actually feel I have an emotional problem. Did you know that?
No.
Yeah, I have a serious mental disability.
I don't think you have an emotional.
I do. I could cry right now on a drop of a hat.
Well, so
I'm very sensitive.
You're passionate.
I'm very sensitive. The thing.
You know, there was a teacher at open school night the other night who said, "I don't know anybody who comes and tells me my son, he's just insensitive." He goes, "Everybody's child is very sensitive. Believe me." Like he was just talking to everybody in general.
Yeah.
But it's, you know, we all have emotions and feelings. It's the people who are on drugs who don't.
I know. It's the people that like a lot of times. I used to see a therapist years ago, and he said, "Tom, you got to get onto these drugs right now." I said, "You know what? Forget it. I'm going to be insane in the membrane in order to survive this
yeah.
freaking merry-go-round that we're on mm-hmm. with, you know, even when President Bush, people say, oh, Tom, what, you only complain about Obama? No. Back when President Bush was president, this show was still on the air. Mm-hmm. I was complaining about President Bush.
I complained about President Bush with the gas prices.
Yeah, I just don't like the idea of government control. I don't think people are that really brilliant that are in, you put these people on a high pedestal that are in government and they're just like me and you. They're just making decisions like me, you know.
I think they're corrupt though. I don't think they're like me and you.
And let's speak about
so
can
corrupt.
We speak about gas prices for a second? What is it? Now America has to get used to the fact that gas is going to hover around $4 a gallon. What, we've come to accept it? We've come to accept it. Doesn't anybody know I'm live on the air? I'm going to put this person on the air. Hold on, because I don't know what this is about. Hello? Hi. Oh, good. Hold on 1 second.
Great.
Okay.
Well, I'm calling with great news. We found your cat. It seems to be doing really well. No sign of injury.
What the frick are you talking about? What are you, an a-hole?
We see your phone number on the ID caller.
Oh, this is like a recording, like a crank call or something. Let me tell you something, pal. You are live on the air on Tom Shields Live. And they probably know it. I wish I could figure out which phone number this is.
Cat?
No, it's a recording. Listen to the friggin' idiot.
Oh, all right. 1 second. Yeah. They're telling me this isn't their cat. Oh, really? Yeah. It must be their own cat.
Oh, gosh. You know,
some freaking mental case.
They have nothing else better to do.
Let me tell you something. Folks, we're going to be back in 2 minutes. I got to have a beverage break.
Okay.
We're going to be talking about, when we come back, we're going to pick up where we left off about the high gas prices. Folks,
And Rachel Maddow,
that's right. I got to show you a picture of Rachel Maddow. I got glasses that she has on in her commercial, and I can't find them anywhere. Where's my little square glasses? Have you seen them around?
I have a great story about glasses today, too. The ones that you were wearing before that they were making you on?
No, not my Ric Flair glasses.
No.
Because I put these on, I have to be real careful. Watch. Woo! You know? Whoa, take it easy, pal. Woo! All right, we'll be back in 2 minutes. We'll be back in 2 minutes, folks. Don't go anywhere. We have to catch a beverage break. We are human. We need a beverage. We need to wet the whistle. You know what I'm talking about? So don't go anywhere. We have a couple of PSAs going on, public service announcements. Some of them are funny. Some of them are very nice. And some of them mean business. There's only three of them. It's a 2 minute break. Don't go anywhere, folks. We'll be right back.
There's no way to hide it. If you drive drunk, we will find you. Cops everywhere are stepping up enforcement and cracking down like never before.
Sir, have you been drinking tonight?
Sir, have you been drinking this evening?
Sir? You've been drinking tonight.
Make no mistake, you will get caught and you will be arrested. Over the limit, under arrest.
Hi, I'm Diana Page. Extraordinary children deserve extraordinary teachers. And extraordinary teachers are the backbone of strong American schools. Visit strongamericanschools.org to see what you can do to help, because our country's only as strong as its schools.
I could never get that right either. But anyhow, folks, we're back from the break. Thanks for hanging out there. Hope you enjoyed those PSAs. But we were talking about freaking gas prices. You know, let me tell you something. Can I go back to my mental capabilities for a minute? Mm-hmm. When I was young, did you ever want to be some... I always wanted to be Superman when I was young. I always wanted to fly. Then I always wanted to be Spider-Man. There was something about me wanting to be a superhero. Do you think that's the reason I can come on this program and talk for 60 minutes about... Because I want to be a superhero. I think I want to change the world. I would love to be a politician, but I don't have the educational background. And if they delved into my history of... I say this
skeletons
guy
would be like
this guy is sicker than you know. But let me tell you something. I have some good ideas. Folks, this is a live program. We're broadcasting live from Connecticut, New Haven, Connecticut. I never like to say the exact area because, you know. But the New Haven, Connecticut area, we're broadcasting live. It is almost 9:35 on the East Coast, mm-hmm. which means it's 6:35 on the West Coast. I love the idea that StickCam gives us the exposure that they do. I wish I could hug one of those guys. I really do.
They're the best.
Because
thank you, StickCam.
I'm telling you, if there is a internet network mm-hmm. that you want to put together, it doesn't have to be totally professional, but if you have something you want to express or an idea of a show, those are the people that if you have somewhat of a quality show, they will give you the exposure, mm-hmm. and they're just terrific. I would not be doing this show right now, to be honest with you, if it wasn't for StickCam. That's the credit that they deserve. That's the appreciation that I have for them for putting this show, the exposure that they give us. How many freaking viewers? 2,700 viewers. I mean, come on. Where are you going to get that on internet television if you don't have people who appreciate the program? We could come on here. We could curse. Mm-hmm. We could use four-letter words, but that's not who we are. Mm-hmm. We're trying to spread a message. We're trying to have people realize that you can be a regular American, but you can still have your voice heard. You can mm-hmm. still express your frustrations with what's going on in the world, and you could take your hand and you could move it back and forth as many times as you want.
And you could bob your head. And you
absolutely.
Want you to
bob
if you don't like it.
Yeah, you got that. You got that move. See, I can't do that head move. Like when you get mad, you get that. Like,
you know what?
Let
it's
me
like
tell
it's
you something.
Indoctrinated into you. When
let
you
me tell
up
you something. Where were you? You didn't grow up in Brooklyn, did you?
No, I grew up on the Lower East Side, Lower Manhattan.
Okay.
Grant Street and East Broadway.
All right. Okay. Because I have a friend that lives in Brooklyn. Is
no,
Brooklyn a rough place?
From Brooklyn. It depends what part of Brooklyn you.
All right.
You know, my mother grew up in a rough area of Brooklyn, in Bushwick. That's
all right.
Where my mother grew up. But I grew up on the Lower East Side, next to the Williamsburg Bridge.
Oh, all right. Okay, good.
Yeah, it was quite an experience.
Yeah.
A lot different from Brantford. That's why sometimes I look at these people like they're insane in the membrane.
Thank you, Cheryl. Cheryl says you are a superhero for the American people, Tom. She abbreviated people, so I had to stutter for a minute. But thank you, Cheryl. And it's for the people that are viewing the broadcast. I mean, come on. We got a lot of... I know that this show airs like every night during the week locally here in the Brantford, Connecticut area. So can we say something about Brantford now? Like, can we complain? I know people that are watching nationally, even if it doesn't affect you totally, you'll like to listen to what goes on locally and what local people on the East Coast can complain about.
I have no complaints about Brantford, I have to be honest
really?
With you. Yeah.
Do you,
I'm pretty happy right now.
Yeah. You know what? I am too. I just wish I had a little more help in my business end, but I'm not going to discuss that on the air.
Let me tell you, today my son is waiting for the bus.
All right.
And he hears a smoke alarm.
All right.
He hears, like, this alarm. And then he's like, I smell smoke. I'm telling you, there's a fire in that house. And
wait a minute, but did he have, like, something special on that gave him these abilities? Come on, tell the whole story.
I can't believe it. My son left today wearing his Clark Kent glasses.
All right, come on, tell the story. This is a good one.
He left going to school today wearing his Clark Kent glasses because Carlos loves Superman.
All right.
Long story short, he goes and he has like his group of buddies that he meets every morning.
All right.
He's like, I'm telling you, that alarm's going off. There's a fire. Him and his friends go over there. They say, you know.
But did anyone else hear this alarm?
Other people heard it. Nobody did anything.
Nobody
people
did.
People didn't know what to do.
But Carlos went into action because he had his Clark Kent.
It had to be the Clark Kent glasses. It had to be. So sure enough, the fire department goes. They say if they would have gotten there like a minute later, the house would have went up in flames. And that's a kid. That's common sense. And that's what we need more
so
of.
So really, basically, Carlos is a hero.
That's right. My baby's a hero.
You should call the papers or something and tell them about this.
I was thinking about him and his friends. And I have to tell you, that Walsh Intermediate School.
Yeah.
Fantastic. I can't say a bad word about their education. He has learned so much. So I can't complain about Branford. Look at those pecs. Is that like pecs?
Folks, I am so into my... You know what, though? I don't have a problem saying that.
There's nothing wrong with that.
Let me tell you something. I'm getting that feeling in my throat again where I almost want to cry. I wish that I can school people who are too bashful to get out and say anything in the world because I was there. You know, that's what we try to do here is to educate and to make people understand that you have to be constructive in life. You can't be like a mental case and run around all the time.
You can't run around just
but you can control yourself and you can express your views. If people don't agree, then you don't have to worry about it. Don't deal with them anymore, you know?
But you have to speak the truth.
You do. And that's the thing that's right. Is when you're speaking about something that you disagree with, there has to be some truth around
right.
it. It can't be just like this made up story, which some people do. Oh, some people make up stories and you could tell them, you could tell right away that they're lying and you don't even want to talk to them. Mm-hmm. But if it's something solid and truthful and you disagree with it, President Obama, for instance, you could be a young person and President Obama only wants to put construction workers back to work. I'm surprised no one comes out and calls him on that. Only construction workers is he's fixated. Oh no, Tom, he's given tax credits to people who hire people. Yeah, this is a jobs bill he's trying. He's not doing it right now. Oh well, the Republican Congress has to pass it first. You know, all it is another stimulus.
And it's more money to give to his cronies and his friends.
Exactly.
Let's be honest, it's right before election time. He's like, I need to pay.
Yeah.
I need to get money into these people's pockets.
Exactly.
I made commitments. I have bills to pay.
People need.
People give me the money. I'll tell you how we spent it. This is crony capitalism in the worst sense.
Right.
That's going on. There's so much corruption. It's making me crazy. Oh my God. You
get me so nervous.
You
get me so scared.
You press that button.
I know. I see the vein. I know.
I'm sorry.
You can cry if you want. Because,
That's the thing is, I'm the opposite. I don't want to cry. I just want to rip somebody's head off. I want to take a liberal and just shake them. And be like, don't you?
When you get mad, you get this masculine thing. When I get mad, I get this feminine thing going. I don't understand what the deal. Do you know?
It's so funny that.
What a switch we do. Yeah, but what was that movie where they switch like the guy becomes the woman becomes the guy? What's that movie? There was a couple of those movies like that.
Oh, that's so
where they like do this funny thing and they wish, boy, I wish I was you, and then like
voo.
Yeah, then like all of a sudden voo, and then here I am, you're me and I'm you. So
well, because it's so frustrating because it's like, don't you see what's in front of you?
I know.
Don't you see that people are unemployed? Don't you see that hope is not a product or anything tangible?
And it's so funny how the liberals, the Democrats all think the same when you ask any of them. I don't know if they're going, they say, well, if you extend unemployment, they'll have more money in their pockets and they'll spend more, which will create more jobs and create more work. Like they actually, I want to throw up right now because they actually believe that because people will have more money in their pockets that they'll go to Walmart and they'll buy a couple of extra things, which will create more tax revenue and will give people the benefit of keeping their job at Walmart because it's busy. That's not the way it works, baby.
That's not the way it works.
That's a short-term fix. And these construction jobs, you build a bridge. What's going to happen when the bridge is built? when it's all done. He keeps talking about infrastructure.
Well, then he should go and say, I need more money to stimulate the
right.
economy.
Right, it's short project. Term. The majority of businesses that create jobs are people that employ 500 employees or less. People like me. I have freaking 6 employees. These are the people that create jobs. If I hire 2 people, and the next business hires 2 people, and the next business hires 2 people, next thing you know, there's going to be 2-3 million people working.
Absolutely.
But he's asphyxiated on the construction workers. I'd like to spit on the ground.
But it's a lie, Tom. He's asphyxiated on giving his friends money. That's why the guy from the freaking solar panel.
The solar panel. He's walking around. You see him walking around last year at the solar panel place?
Oh, I know.
He's smiling. Hi, I'm President Obama.
I know. How about
we give you $500 million of money that's not even, you know, it's taxpayer money. So let me just give it to you, you know, because it's a green job. Solar panels are going to be everywhere. It's going to save the world. Mm-hmm. What happens? They go out of freaking business less than a freaking year. What happened to that $500 billion? Right, I'll show you where that $500 billion should have went. You take that $500 billion and you stick it right here, baby. You stick it where the sun don't shine because it doesn't even matter. You may as well have taken that $500 billion, drive down the interstate, and throw it out the freaking window. Throw it out the window so that the people on the interstate could pick up the money and then maybe go spend it at Walmart, which would create more tax revenue and have the people with more job security because they're spending money. That $500 million. What is Austin Powers? $500 million. And what is? And then number two. His number two, which was. Do you remember the actor's name?
I know who he is, but he's the one who does the reverse home mortgage insurance.
Right, number two. Who is number two in Austin Powers? Who's number two in the freaking Austin Powers movie? I can't think. Somebody help me out.
Guy.
It's the guy that was real. He's real suave. His wife drowned in the freaking ocean. Well, who was the guy? Robert Wagner. Thank you very much.
Yes.
High five, Cheryl. Thank you, Robert Wagner. And he comes out and says, "Well, to tell you the truth, there, Dr. Evil, $1 million really isn't that much money anymore." So what they should have said was, "To tell you the truth, there, Dr. Evil, I mean President Obama, $500 million really isn't that much money anymore. $500 million. So why don't you give $500 million? Because $500 million is not worth that much anymore. So just don't worry about it. It's other people's money.
Yeah.
It's not his. Other people's money. Let's give it to these solar panel people."
Absolutely.
So that they can create more green jobs. They started laying off. This is the president that is making decisions on the economic future of this country. This is the president that's making decisions on how we should spend our tax dollars. He just gave $500 million to the freaking green job people because number two said to him, which was probably Joe Biden is number two,
Or that other guy, though. I think it's really number two. It's not Anthony Weiner, I almost said. It's, who's that guy? Not Emanuel, not Rahm Emanuel. The other one who went
Ben
back
Bernanke.
To Chicago.
Oh.
No,
oh,
Bernanke
oh,
Bernanke
oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Come on, help me out.
The freaking, the Emanuel.
Not Rahm Emanuel, oh. The other one.
I thought he was the one. That
David
went back.
Axelrod.
Oh.
Dave, is
he an odd-looking man?
Oh, he's evil.
He's
the number two, I have a feeling, sometimes.
He looks like my old roommate, which I don't want to say
Axelrod
anything.
I think David Axelrod is from New York, too. I think
he's got that really messy hair and the mustache.
Yeah, like, he looks like I'm crazy smart. Like, he's trying to be Einstein.
He looks like the kind of guy that you'll find on Craigslist looking for a casual encounter of some sort. He looks, I'm just saying.
David Axelrod, I gotta tell you, I think that he really does a lot of things behind the scenes because he's always in charge
I
of
think
campaign.
He does a lot of things behind closed doors that, and then he opens the door and says, I have to be David Axelrod now and I better pull my pants up. Speaking of pulling their pants up, all right, I'm sorry, folks.
Oh, gosh, this is great.
Oh, man. Hey, where did we go?
I'll tell you, I think that it's unbelievable, though, the crony capitalism that's going on. And the thing is, nobody want, like, liberals don't want to say, you know what, it's true. Obama was a mistake. He is inexperienced. He is wrecking this country. There is crony capitalism. He's not helping anybody. He doesn't get the economic situation.
Exactly.
They don't want to say it. They don't want to admit it. Hope is not something that you anybody should run on.
It's just, it's and
Don, there's only one person you should get hope from, God. You pray, he gives you hope. Not any person.
When I'm going to sleep at night, I watch a Fox News and I listen to all the crap. When I go to sleep, let me ask you something. Mm-hmm. Do you know anyone that wears pajamas anymore when they go to sleep? Do people actually wear pajamas? Do you wear pajamas?
I wear pajamas.
You wear pajamas.
Well, I have kids, so I have to.
All right. That's understandable. I just don't know anyone that wears pajamas anymore. I heard somebody, my friend the other day says, yeah, this and that, I still had my pajamas on. I was like, wait a minute. Pajamas. I don't wear freaking pajamas. I walk around, you know.
Well, that's because you don't have
What do you wear? The ones with little fruity things on them?
I did not have any pajamas. Let me put it to this way. There was a time in my life I did not have pajamas, but once you have children, you have pajamas.
All right. That's understandable.
You have to have pajamas, you know, because you're like getting up and, Mom, I need something to drink. It's the middle of the night. You have to have on pajamas.
Chicago Dave, are you making fun of my Spider-Man PJs with the feet?
Even my husband has pajamas. I never put him on a pair of pajamas either.
Let me see. Oh, you better believe it. Amy behind the glass, Oompa Loompa, Axelrod is really a devil. He's a very odd looking. You know, there's some people in politics that you can look at and say, you know something? I want to sit down and talk to this guy. I wouldn't mind going out to dinner. I wouldn't mind going having a beer with this guy.
You would want to go but out when you,
no, I'm just saying there are some.
Yeah.
Like Rick Perry, I see him in the presidential. You son of a bitch. Ooh. I would want to hang out with Rick Perry. I would want to understand what his views are. I would want to listen to what he has to say. Mm-hmm. Look at that. I lost the freaking stream. That's all right. We can see what's going on over here. Just a stick cam. We only got 10 minutes left. Give us a little uppy. Give us a little uppity, baby. They put us down about the 15th down on the row. But that's because they gave us a lot of exposure.
Yeah,
I don't mind.
We were number one for
I get
a long
spoiled.
Time.
You know, let's get back to PJs. I don't wear pajamas. I walk around in my jeans and everything else. Then when it's time to go to sleep, I just take the jeans off. I walk around in my underwear. That's it. And then I go to sleep. And then I watch Fox News. Mm-hmm. And then I think about certain things, and I go to sleep.
Who do you usually, forget it. I'm not even
yeah,
sure
I know.
Paul.
Let me see. What we got going on here? Ha, ha, ha. Cheryl says, I don't wear PJs.
Cheryl.
All right. Then she comes right out with no naked.
Boy.
With explanation points.
Sure.
You're right. We have girls. Only my husband needs to wear the pajamas. Amy behind the glass. But I tell you what. Oompa Loompa says, I went from buff to PJs because of the kids. Life sucks. Oompa Loompa is funny. Oompa Loompa,
he is funny.
He is funny. Oh, man. I need more freedom to move around. Well, I'll tell you what. We've got the phone number on the screen. Nobody wants to call and be our friend. That's all right. Go to the website. Find out.
Well, I mean, please, God forbid they press one of our buttons. You'll be crying. I'll be...
I know. I know. I'll be vomiting. You know, what's that? Wait, did you ever watch South Park? Where there's like...
Oh, yes!
When they fall in love.
Yeah.
When the girl falls in love
Is
with the
Kenny,
boy.
One
of them, not the one that always dies. There's another one that falls in love, and as soon as they get nervous, they just
yes.
throw up. That's
yeah.
me. I'm freaking as old as I am. I still am. I have an emotional issue. I'll watch a commercial with two puppy dogs on it, and I'll start to cry. I have to walk away.
How about the Olympics? Do you cry at the Olympics?
No, I don't care about the Olympics.
Really?
Yeah. I never watch the Olympics anymore. I don't get excited about the Olympics because what's going on across the world? What's going on? You know, I watched this thing on YouTube of the president's speech about he came on a few days ago and said something about how he wants to extend unemployment. He wants the same old bull crap that he always talks about. He wants to hire, let the construction workers get back to work. You know how many construction workers need paychecks? Can you just kick the freaking TV when he says that? Then
it's like, how about the rest of us?
So I wrote a little comment on the YouTube and against Obama, and somebody says he's the best president we've ever had. He stopped the war in Iraq. He stopped the war in Afghanistan. He said, now these are the mental things. There's still a war in Iraq. There's still a war in Afghanistan.
There's a war in Libya.
There's a war. There's Americans in Libya that are putting their life on the line. For what reason, I don't even know. Yeah, I mean, and then he says, and he's helped the economic crisis by the stimulus. You know, people are not living. You know, those are probably people collecting government assistance and welfare who shouldn't even be allowed to vote.
But Tom, how about the government workers too? That their salaries, like, you know, you had a certain number making 170, now you have so many more making 170 a year. It's like, how come nobody in the private sector is getting raises and we're paying more taxes to go to these raises? For what?
And it's funny,
like,
how
everybody has to feel the pain.
And it's funny how everyone blames President Bush.
Oh, of course.
But I mean, I have to say, President Bush rushed for the first stimulus to get it into the system. But guess who followed his coattails? President Obama. President Obama, rather than seeing what it was going to do, he followed his coattails and shoved the stimulus down our throats.
TARP was the Troubled Asset Relief Program.
Right.
And that was to help the banks, so that way we didn't go into a total economic depression. The stimulus was to create jobs.
Yeah.
So they were two totally different things.
Yeah. But
he took the TARP money and then used it and gave it to the car industry after the banks paid him back.
And that was the biggest joke was cash for clunkers, because there are automobile dealerships that have not received the refund for getting involved, where they took the hit and they want the government to pay them the money they promised, but they still haven't received it. They're still hurting. So that's the government.
And how many people do you see driving clunkers?
That was a joke. That was a joke. That was a short-term fix that wasted the American people's money.
And that didn't help anybody.
Nobody. And TARP was supposed to help the banks and help the mortgage companies. It was supposed to help homeowners and everything else. Nothing. I was one of those homeowners that needed my mortgage to be refinanced through the government. Mm-hmm. Nothing. It's a bunch of bull crap. When they say they're going to help you, they're not going to help you. If you're not delinquent, 3 months delinquent in your mortgage, they don't even want to talk to you. Doesn't matter if you're struggling to make that payment where you almost can't even put food on the table, but you got to be 3 months delinquent in order for them to even look.
And that's what frustrates so many Americans.
Let me tell you, this show gets me to, I'm almost crying, and I swear I'm not exaggerating. The thing is, I have a lot of estrogen in my blood. I had a friend tell me that. Do you know that I don't want to get involved in that. Never mind.
What?
No, it was something. I had a friend tell me that too. You got too much estrogen in you. Hey, I go to the gym. Uh-huh. I work out hard and I sweat. I don't know what's going on here. All I could say is Obama's new snitch site. Yeah, he's got a site now where you could snitch on people. Like people who aren't agreeing with him or saying bad things.
It's
so Soviet Union. And how had SARS? Yes, the Soviet Union. Obama has a ton of them.
The czars.
How about czars? Yeah. Yes, the Soviet Union has a ton of them. That's what he probably meant to say. But let's see.
I know. There are quite a few czars.
I believe the guy that created cash for clunkers is Obama's new economic... Let me tell you something. How disgusted are you about Obama talking about keeping jobs in America and the General Electric...
And Jeffrey Elmo, yes. The guy who took the jobs from Wisconsin!
Who was sitting next to... Michelle Obama during his speech when he was talking. This country, folks, is so screwed up and so corrupt
lies.
When are we going to get somebody in there that's, you know what?
That was the time for someone to say, you lie!
Just put Rick Perry in there. Just put him in there. People may not agree with his illegal immigrant policy, or people may not agree, but let me tell you, get him in there. He's a good-looking guy. He stands up strong. He reminds me of Reagan. He's going to bring this country back. He brought Texas back from a brink. He created more jobs than anybody. Bring this guy in. Forget about crazy eye Michelle Bachmann. She's freaking crazy. She's, you know, I mean, she's like crazy.
But, you know, there's certain things that she says.
No, she absolutely.
And then there are other things that she just goes right off the cliff.
Yeah, exactly. Like, oh, some Michelle, very good things. But she's just crazy.
It's true.
She's
you
a crazy
really
woman.
Good is that Newt Gingrich? It's too bad nobody takes him seriously.
You know why? Because he has a checkered past. He was cheated on his wife. He's a womanizer. He has a real.
He uses Tiffany's credit.
He wears women's underwear. He's very, very strange. I just assume.
Uh-oh, now we'll see Newt, come on! Maybe he'll come up on the poll numbers. I mean, it couldn't hurt.
He'll come up on the poll.
But
I'm
I'll
sorry.
Tell you, man, Newt Gingrich had some good one-liners.
He does. He really is. He's a very bright man. He's experienced. And a lot of people are saying, Tom, what political background do you... We're Americans. What? We watch TV. We listen to the radio. We find out where our news is coming. What? We don't have the right to say something? What, the people like Vinnie Penn are the only one? You ever listen to Vinnie Penn? He's actually kind of good, but his voice is so annoying that I swear I want to rip my freaking eyes out of my head just from listening. I'm sorry. I just had to get that in real quick. Well, I'll tell you what. There I go with that freaking jaw again. I just watched it there.
I can't believe it's almost an hour.
It's done. We got to actually start the.
So fast.
We got to start the exit music already. We got to start the exit music. Folks, thanks a lot. Let me tell you, Cheryl, I love the idea that you don't wear pajamas to bed. I got something to think about tonight. I tell you what, high five. Thanks for putting in some good stuff. Amy behind the glass. Charlie! Chicago Dave, thanks for checking in, babe. Curl Well, haven't seen you in a while. Minnesota. We forgot to say hi to Minnesota tonight. What's up, Minnesota? We didn't forget Minnesota. We sometimes, last week, because we were so, like, out of it, we got like double the energy tonight, so I apologize. Oompa Loompa, Cheryl again. You fan of three. Does that mean something? That might be a sexual connotation, which I enjoy. I'm really mental. I am insane in the membrane. Can I just look at Rachel Maddow so that I can have something to dream about before I go to bed?
I didn't have 9 minutes. That's the thing.
This is, what does she think? What does she think if she puts on a pair of glasses that it's going to make her look important, or if she puts on a funny hard hat? Look at her in the Hoover Dam. What is she doing? Look at the glass. Look. Can you just look? Look at her. What is she thinking? That's Rachel Maddow in a freaking hoodie with a black T-shirt on. And that's Pat. Did you ever see Saturday Night Live?
Absolutely.
You couldn't tell if Pat was a man or a woman. That's Pat right there.
She is Pat.
I'm sorry. There, look at what is what. Take the glasses off. It doesn't do you any good. I don't know. I can't figure it out. But anyhow, folks, thanks for watching the program tonight. I hope you enjoyed it. Go to the website. Find out more of what we're about. We only have like 30 seconds left, so I can't even say goodbye as much as I want to. But everybody, I love you. I love you for watching the show. Stick Cam, I love you for the exposure that you give us.
Bye, everybody.
And that's pretty much it.
I